The disaster, which lasted 2 hours, affected especially Kagadi Town Council and Pachua Sub-County. Crop gardens such as coffee, cocoa, cassava, sweet potatoes, maize and bananas were destroyed. School and church buildings also suffered destruction. I have lost my residential house and 4 acres of cassava. I was looking forward to selling the cassava to pay fees for my children. I hope the Office of the Prime Minister and Disaster Preparedness can come to my rescue. I have lost 2 acres of sweet potatoes and 3 acres of bananas. I now have to find a way to feed my family. I hope we can get some help. I have 4 children in school, and I rent a house for accommodation. After losing crops in my garden, I wonder where I am going to get the money. By press time, debris from the ruins could be seen piled up in gardens, homes, and by the roadside. In Kwania District, the Diocese of West Lango has partnered with World Vision to combat violence against children. At an event at St. Peter's Cathedral Church in Adugo Town Council, the two parties signed a deal to work together for the next 15 years. Despite the national strategy to end child marriage and teenage pregnancy that was launched by the government in 2015, the problem persists.
Thank you so much, Amele Bunlon.
In northern Uganda, the prevalence of child marriage is at 59%, according to a report by the United Nations Children's Fund. In Kabarole District, a total of 702 teenage pregnancies have been recorded in a space of just 6 months, according to data from the health office. The data was collected from the health centers between the months of January and June this year.
We have the challenge of teenage pregnancy, and according to our data, we have sub-counties which have high percentage of pregnancy among adolescents, among which Algongo is the heads of the sub-counties. Algongo has, out of the mothers who come, 28% are teenager, which is at a high risk. And then Algongo is followed by Achibale. Hachibale with a percentage of 24%. And Kasenda sub-county.
To solve the problem, Kabarole District and Foot Portal, in conjunction with the Sexual Reproductive Health and Rights Alliance Uganda, launched a one-week campaign aimed at providing health talks in selected schools, health facilities and sub-counties.
We are going to have a dialogue, and we hope even our king here to be around. So we are going to discuss the same issues. What is causing those high numbers of teenage pregnancies? What is causing the high numbers of the sexually transmitted infections within the sub-region of Rwenzori? And then we'll have commitments from the leaders of the kingdom. We are going to have commitments from the leaders of the district. We are going to have commitments from the youth leaders themselves.
The teachers in school to give age-appropriate information to the very many young people, so that we can do away with the raging numbers of teenage pregnancies, of school dropouts. Because you know, when a girl gets pregnant, obviously she's going to take 2 years leave because she's pregnant, she has to breastfeed, the child has to have a little bit of independence before they go back to school.
Report by Andrew Musinguzi, Solomon Okabo and Jonan Tusingwire for the news.